A very good morning to everybody. Our respected sir, secretary and curator, Dr. Jayanta Sengupta, and administrative officer, and we are having an expert from technology, who is an expert in the field of RFID, who is a resource person for today's presentation. So we have, we are all aware, actually, that VMH is undergoing a tagging of all the artifacts in the galleries, and we have completed a wholesome of 6,021 tagging of artifacts, and mainly the Darbar Hall, it is a fully tagged gallery, old restoration part, Royal Gallery, we have fully tagged it, and the newly, the Daniel store, it has been already been tagged. So it is an in-house training program for the participants from VMH, and it consists of a theoretical part in the first phase, a PowerPoint presentation on RFID, and next part is a practical demo, a live demo on how to that device been used to tag a particular objects in the galleries and how to count them and to locate the particular objects, the movement of the objects from one store, and also the security point of view of the objects. So it all will be covered by the RFID. So so I now request our director, sir, to inaugurate
the program. Thank you, Abhijit, and a very good morning, everybody. Today, we are here for training on a program that we have started quite a few months ago. In fact, we are very thankful to Mr. Ravindran from TechNoir, whom I have been meeting for several months now in both the Indian Museum and here. And he and his team from TechNoir has helped us along in completing the first phase of the RFID project. And now we are here to take training because like online ticketing, which we launched yesterday, like CISF, which we are going to introduce exactly 1 week from now, next Monday. RFID is also a new thing. And whenever we introduce any new thing, like many years ago when we introduced computerization, we have to, because this is a change to the system itself, therefore everybody preferably needs to understand how the system works, needs to understand the utility of the system, why it is important to have this system, and to train ourselves in this new program so that RFID, which has been introduced in museums across the Ministry of Culture to track objects. It's more of a, at least at this point, it is more of a tracking device and a tracking a tool rather than something that ensures foolproof security of objects. But it is something like we have loaned out our famous painting by Johann Zoffany, Claude Martin and his friends, to CSMVS in Mumbai for their exhibition, India and the World. And that has an RFID, as Abhijit said. The Darbar Hall is now a fully tagged gallery. And when the object was taken out on loan, we requested CSMVS not to tamper with the tag. And that's what has been done. And that's very convenient for us because we can keep track of the object in the database. So it's a training program in which we all of us here, who may not handle RFID tags directly, but still it is very important to understand the functioning of the system. So we are very thankful to Mr. Ravindran for spending his valuable time to train us. And like everything new, we should embrace this system and we should ensure that it is, it operates on its maximum efficiency here. And that depends only on our ability to get ourselves trained to use the full functionality of the system. So that is what Mr. Ravindran will do first starting with a PowerPoint on you know, the general significance of the RFID system, and then he will give us a demo. But it's very important to make this session interactive. So it is very important for you to ask questions. Any questions are very welcome. No questions are inappropriate or, you know. So whatever appears to be not perfectly clear, please ask questions. We are very new. Mr. Ravindra knows this, that we are new. So we will have questions which will sometimes indicate that we are new to this, but that is very natural. That is only to be expected. Because unless we ask the questions and unless we really grill Mr. Ravindran to give us all the clues to this system, we won't be able to utilize this training usefully. So once again, thank you all of you for coming here for this training. We all look forward to a very useful training and to using this system with maximum efficiency. We are very thankful to Mr. Ravindran for coming all the way here to train us. So he is also part of this team, like he is part of the team in all other museums. So this session should be on good teamwork and good interaction, good questions and answer, all of which will reflect on the on our efficiency in using this system. So thank you very much. I will beg your leave, beg everybody's leave, including Mr. Ravindran's, because I have to rush to a meeting with the Secretary Culture at the National Library, which starts at 12 noon. So I will not be able to, you know, learn these new things in the training, but I will catch up with you. So thanking you, I will take your leave, and again, please use the training as best as you can. Thank you very much. Yeah,
thank you, sir.
Good morning to everybody. I am Ravindran from Technovar Solutions. Before we go into the subject, I just want to give a small brief who we are, what we are, and what we are doing it. We are based in Chennai, head office, and we have a branch office in USA, Florida, and also we have a branch office in Brunei Darussalam. That's very close to Malaysia, Malaysia and Singapore. This is our core job, what Technovar is involved. We are into materials management, maintenance management, RFID technology, engineering services, and related IT and software development. I think anybody, please stop me if you want to raise a question. I like questions. Please stop me. Okay, I'm ready to answer. Does it, everybody knows what is materials management and maintenance management? It's all related to the big industries like fertilizer and oil industry, gas industry. So where we do all the materials and asset management. And RFID technology related with that one. The concept is same. The same concept has been used in museums also now. We also do engineering service like telecom erection and commissions. That's a different division. And software division is there. Myself, I'm handling materials management, maintenance management, and the software division and RFID, I'm handling myself. Engineering division is separate, somebody else is handling in our company. This is our some of our major clients where we have been handling it. We are in Brunei, that is a petroleum industry. We do metals management, RFID. And in West Africa, Kinross Gold Mine. There's a Gokul Das in Bangalore. And again, gas plant, BLH is a gas plant in Brunei. We also did some UTA for the government of India. And BGC is in Iraq. Myself, I was there in Iraq for 6 months. And complete this project. Once we complete this session, I'll be bringing down the next line is the museums in this slide. Let us go into the subject. Basically, this RFID technology we're using in museum, and it is related, again, there is integration with, we are providing a software called UCAT, which is getting integrated with the RFID, and also we are giving another software called Analytics, which is not in the scope, but we are providing you, which can give the management information and graphics and all the dashboard details it will give you. So all three are integrated. Let us see one by one how it is being done. What is RFID? I think from here on you should question me. RFID is it's divided into three components. One is the RFID tags. Other one is the RFID readers. The other one is the host computer. So all three together forms a complete system of the RFID technology. The beauty of this one is without in contact, within the 10 feet or 15 feet range, if it comes into contact, it picks up the signal. That is the beauty of the RFID. Why we are going to RFID? You might have seen the barcode system. You need to go there and scan it very close to it. Then only it will pick up. But this one is within the 10 feet range. If it picks up the signal, it will immediately respond. Any questions? How it works? Basically, there are two type of RFID tags. One is active, other one is passive. Here we are using only passive tags. Active tags we are not using it because that is a little more expensive. What is the difference between the tags? I'll tell you. Active tags needs a power. That means a small battery or some sort of power it requires. And it generates a signal and passes back. Whereas the passive tags, what we have used here, doesn't have any power at all. It's just a small circuit chip, and it doesn't do anything at all. Then how it works? Once the reader passes the signal, and when the reader's signal comes in contact with the tag, then the tag will reply back, yes, I am here. That's what it does. Otherwise, it's just a small dead piece. Any questions? Yeah, yes, please.
Our museum, which tag has been used?
Passive tags, we are using it. And the radio frequency, the ultra high frequency, radio frequency, we are using it. And the range is 865 to 868 megahertz. That is what allowed in India. Every country has got their own range. And India is allowed to use this international design, actually. And in India, we are allowed to use only this range for RFID technology. Whereas the readers, what we are providing you, it can cover throughout the world. But the chips, the RFID technology, what we are pasting here, that falls under this range. What are the devices the RFID has got? You have the tag, you might have seen already. There are readers, an antenna, software, and a host computer. All this forms the complete system. You can operate the RFID technology if all these devices are there. This is the handle reader we are providing you. These two together it has got the, it's a reader and both antenna. About the tags, the RFID tags, there are many different types of tags are there. Here what we see is the inlay tags, cable tie, locket tag, and anti-metal tag, weatherproof, waterproof, and miniature tags. In our scope, we are given only these three type of tags. We are not covered other tags. But there is a requirement. For example, in your armored gallery, these three type of tags cannot be used because it will not work on the metal surface. So you need an anti-metal tag that is here. So that was not covered in the scope, so we did not use it. We plan to cover it in the second phase. because originally it was not who the tender was made. It was they did not cover this part. So in the second phase, we are planning to cover all the shortfallings.
I think we are going fast. No questions.
In our garden, Victoria Memorial Garden, there are statues there. So the tagging of the statues have been completed. So which type of tag there you had implemented?
It was inlet tags with adhesive where we covered it. But temporarily we covered it. But in actually, strictly speaking, we need to have the weatherproof tag.
That's why I'm asking.
And since it is not there in the scope, I'm not in a position to give you.
Okay.
For time being, we have covered with the inlet tags.
But
because
this is not weatherproof, no?
So no, it is not weatherproof. But we ensure that no rain or nothing falls on it.
Okay.
But in the second phase, we will be again re-look into it.
You had put it as like that weather is not affected the
yeah,
tag.
That's true.
But how it is tagged in statues? না মানে কোন জায়গাটায় দেওয়া হয়েছে ও ও সো অনলি দ্য ইনসাইড দ্য স্ট্যাচুস ইউ হ্যাড ইমপ্লিমেন্টেড
ইয়া
আউট বাট ইন গার্ডেন ইউ হ্যাড নট ইমপ্লিমেন্টেড ওকে ওকে থ্যাঙ্ক ইউ
দিস স্লাইড ইজ জাস্ট ফর ইওর নলেজ ওয়্যার অল দিস আরএফআইডি টেকনোলজি ইজ বিং ইউজড দে ইউজ ইট ইন হেলথ কেয়ার. Particularly now, government is insisting in all the hospitals that the newborn babies, they have to put a tag to and connect with the mother. So there is a compulsion is there from the government and it is being implemented now. We are also in the race and we are planning to do in Andhra Pradesh for the government. It's used in supply chain management. That is all the tracking of inventory and assets. We do it. Museums, we do it. Oil and gas. Yeah, we use it in oil and gas industry, particularly when the crude oil drilling takes place. They drill up to 10,000 feet, and those drill bits are diamond tipped. And protecting that diamond tip drilling bits are very essential for the industries. Sorry? Inventory? Yeah, that's right. I'm coming one by one. So they started using in jewelry also, jewelry shops, because very high value metal piece, gold. Document tracking also is being done, because it moves when the document moves from table to table, they want to need to know where the files are there. So you can track that also. They started using in library. Do you have library here?
Yeah.
I think it's the right time because we are providing the system. You don't have to invest further. All you need is the tags and our service. The same system can be extended. Otherwise, you need to buy a separate complete system. So whatever the system and software we are providing you, you can extend that for the library also. Okay? Okay. No, that is the exhibition. What I'm saying is a library. It's the libraries you are using it, right? The books are taken out for reading and again keeping it back. Those can be tracked. Your library operation I'm talking. So you can connect this software what we are giving you. You can extend that service also. So you don't have to invest on hardware and software, nothing. It's already there. Only thing we need to collect the information and put it in the database and extend the service. That you need to think about it. The facility is there already. It's also used in schools and colleges for the attendance purpose. The students, the moment they enter the gate, attendance is marked. Or even if it goes out in between also, it tracks. The attendance is marked. It's being used in humans. They started using already. It not had come to India. Okay. In Israel, they insert this part permanently because they have problems with their neighbor countries like Palestine and Lebanon. So they want to track those who are not having tags. Because these people come inside and all the shooting and bombing, everything takes place, you know. So to protect their own people, they tag their own people. And those who are not having tag, they catch it. I can show you the slide, how it is doing. This is the tag insertion of the human. You can see, this is the rice grain. You know the rice? Just for your comparison, what is the size of this one? It's like a small rice grain. They insert it. And it is connected with the GPS. You see here? You can see the tag. But only thing, in India, if you do that one, you lose the privacy.
So, sir, things that now VMH is having the tagging of the artifacts, then the appropriate authority can think of tagging of the employees also for the human tracking identification for the staffs.
You can. If you are using ID card, right?
Yeah.
We can put inside the ID card.
Even
and you have to make it compulsory, everybody has to wear. So for that, you can track. And again, you need to have a fixed reader and antenna at the gate. So if you do that one, yes, anytime you go walk in or walk out, you will know it. And the software what we are providing you, any incident happens, immediately an email is triggered and goes to your boss.
How it is functioning at that institutions?
The same pattern. They have an ID card, right? So it is inserted inside the ID card. Now let us talk about the software, what we are providing you. It's called UCAT. And this has got components with the RFID and analytics. We'll see each one separately. All three put together, we are giving a software for the RFID technology. You may get this RFID independently, where the RFID device manufacturer gives you some small software. It will work only on that one. But we are providing a separate software called UCAT, which has got all the facilities. And you can run your reports. You can do it whatever way you want it. It is more user-friendly. We can show that. We'll show the demo on that one later on, once we finish this one. Everybody knows about analytics, right? So any incident or any movement takes place, it's on real time, the information goes to the analytics and you can generate a report immediately. Everything is on real time only. There is no waiting time there. Basically, UCAT is a cataloging tool. The concept is cataloging. Whether you catalog materials or objects or any matters, it has got own templates, where the templates got the attributes and the values so you need to fill up. And everything, and there is a section-wise, gallery-wise, it has been categorized. I'll show you the sites afterwards. All put together forms the UCAT software. It is being developed by ourselves from Technor Solutions. And it's not purchased outside, we have developed our own. And it has been customized to museum's requirement. Just a slide, how it looks, the home page of the UCAT. We captured for Victor Memorial your photos and inserted there. And this is the template. We'll show you the demo, how it works out. Just for your understanding, we are showing. We already talked about it. The wireless techno RFID and the integration with UCAT. Any questions? UCAT with analytics models, we already talked about it. Basically, it gives an analysis in a graphical way. What is the percentage and how it is, what has happened. We'll see in the demo afterwards. This is how the analytic dashboard you can see. This has got a facility where you can generate a report, but day-wise, number of days wise, weekly wise, monthly wise, annual wise, whichever the way you want it, you can generate. So analytics will give you, once you complete your inventorying the complete thing, once you go back to your computer, the system will generate which is not counted, how many was counted per each calorie, how many was not counted. Then you can specifically go and check that object, why it is not counted. It is there or not. Normally, it counts everything. If anything is not counted, you will know exactly which one is not counted, which object and which gallery it is not counted. So you can go and verify only for that. I know you people are taking inventory for the whole museum. How much time it takes? Complete object inventory. Yeah, for checking. Not tagging, checking inventory. You have to... No, I'm asking to take an inventory, the complete museum, how much time it takes, how many days it takes? Not RFID, generally. See, you got a list. This gallery, so much of objects are there. But somebody has to verify, right? Once in a while, everything is there or not. How much time it takes? How much time it takes? Yeah. Yeah. This will take 1 hour. For your 1 year is equal to one hour. You hold your handle reader, you just walk across, it's counted. So, yes. So, almost every day you can ensure, yes, everything is perfect. This is the complete system. This is the tax.
Identification hobe ekta stamp cabinet.
Sir, one thing I wanted to ask you, that when at the Darbar Hall, in the painting, that is frame is wooden, and when tagging this your tag, then that is not fixing properly. When we are doing cleaning one by one painting, and we can find that your tag is, that adhesive is not proper, such a way to tag, when we are cleaning, it's sometimes coming off.
Okay.
So what you have to think about your adhesive, how which better adhesive can be used for, might be it is wooden, for metal might be something other thing, but wooden frame, we already find out our restoration unit that tag is not properly tagging off, fixed on into the frame. That
okay. Anyway, we are having the second phase. We will verify the tone and ensure that it is all properly fixed. But the main reason is, I can see this is the same problem that everywhere I came across. Because of the dust, before we tag it, it should be cleaned properly. Otherwise, the adhesive will come out. That issue is there. Yeah. How? Its life is 50 years.
50 years?
Yeah.
So no need to any preservation of the tagging or cleaning, what you are saying here?
No. Before tagging, pasting, you need to clean properly for the adhesive to stick on properly.
No, I am telling the tagging, suppose 1 inch by 1/2 inch tagging dimension is. It has been fixed here. Okay. So how can I go into the tagging zone to clean it? It will be cleaned from outer.
Yeah, you can normal way you can clean it. It doesn't do anything. It will not affect.
Okay.
Thank you. No. No. What I was telling was, we need to clean properly before we stick it. We have to ensure that. Otherwise, the water or the dust is remain there. The adhesive will get pasted and it is bound to come out.
Is by mistake, by somehow one chip is come out from the object.
Yes.
What will be the next course of action?
Yeah. If it comes out, then we have to. That's what. When you do the inventory, this will not read. Then you have to go back and see why it has not read. You need to identify what is the problem. whether the object is there or not, or if the object is there, why it is not reading. Then you need to check the next stage, where is the chip. If the chip is not there or stolen or somewhere gone, you have to write one more chip and paste it.
We have a cabinet that is called Bigla cabinet. There are many stamps, around 10,000. So it is like a cabinet that one sheet is there, that is a fiber sheet and fiberglass and two fiberglass in one panel. And there is the stamps had been putted in this two fiberglass between this board, acid-free board, and then stamps are fixed there. But the tag you had done, your people, that on the fiber sheet. So when the stamps we are moving for now digitization purpose with the approval of our director. So how it is detected that stamps from in between the fiberglass stamps we had moved.
You mean to say you are removing from the away from the tag?
Yeah. Tag is on fiber sheet.
Okay.
The tag is here. There is a gap inside, and stamps are put here. We are taking out this stuff from this cabinet. Okay. But
tags are there.
Understood. Understood.
So can it be located that stamps have moved? I think so.
No, it will not.
Yeah, that's the problem. So
it will not.
Yeah. So is there any solution to, what is the solution for this?
I need to come and see that one.
Yeah, I think so, because in your practical session, we can see, show you this.
Yeah,
packet.
Sure.
Yeah.
We'll see that one and physically we'll see and see how we can do that one. Mm. So this is a reader, this is the middleware where the UCAT comes in, which can be connected to any desktop because it's a web-based tool and you can access from your home also, only display access. Whoever has given the ID and password, they can even access from your home also because it's a web-based software. These some of the importance of why we tag the objects. Misplaced objects can be found. In fact, when we are doing in a National Museum, while tagging process when we're doing it, we found ourselves there was the objects and whatever the accession code written was not matching. It was misplaced actually. The object was misplaced. The board was there, but the object was placed. No, that's okay. What I'm saying is, forget about RFID. The accession number and the description, everything was there, next. But the picture was, object was wrongly placed. So when we are doing the tagging from the database, it was not matching with our thing. What it was, computer says is something and what you have, we thought we made a mistake. So then we found out, no, it was... object was misplaced. Then we told them and they came and replaced it. And it is being there for years. Nobody knew. Now, what I'm saying is, this can be tracked, even if you misplace also. This is our scope of work, what we have been given. Totally 10,000 objects. We covered 6,021 so far. And because of the other tag types were not there, in the scope of work. So we decide to move to those things to the second phase. These are all the activities we have completed in this RFID technology. Okay, any questions? We almost came to the end. Any questions? Yeah, we'll show. No, we almost came to the end now. You're at the end of the thing, okay? Any questions? Yeah, can you see these tags? There is a coin kept next to it, just for your comparison sake. How big is the tag? This is called the miniature tags. It has got But this is not there in the scope, so I'm not able to provide you. So we decide to cover in the second phase. See, we have done the tagging for all the objects. We came across in each museum what all the shortcomings, what all type of objects you have, what type of tags are required. We already noted down though. So those things we'll be proposing now. So the second phase, the number of objects to be covered, and I need the list from you, the category wise. I don't need exactly how much, at least approximately. Say metal tags, metal objects. Okay, we can take that one. Do you want to tag even the coins also? No. Coins, you have any box or a protector something? Oh, okay, okay. Okay. But the paper objects, we cannot stick on directly on that one. We will not. You can put in a plastic cover. Yeah, every paper, fine. So I will take those categories, whatever the list you have provided. Okay. But these papers, you need to tell us how we can do it. Metal will go, we have to get. Yes. Okay. Yeah, we can, as per this slides, now I think RFID is understood, and I want to know. Huh? Yeah, this is over. Now he has to, we need to give the demo. We'll see the UCAT software demo. Sorry, there is no network actually in this room, so we are finding difficult to connect. This is a home page. You might have seen already, I showed you already. The next screen comes is the member, that is a login. So this we need to assign to those who needs access to this software. And it has to be decided by whoever is the custodian of this software. And there will be three profiles. One is only display access. Other one is display with edit access. Other one is create, edit, and display. The three profiles will be assigned. So when a person you are giving ID and password, you need to assign the profile, whether he requires only display or he needs a edit facility also. But you need to restrict the edit and creation, because you should not give to everybody. Only those who are responsible, only they should be having that one. Rest all can have the display access. Yes.
This is the menu for displaying the items. This is the artifacts. Artifacts you can filter by in reserve, displayed, and all. You can see the item which is present in reserve. So you can filter by search by category, search by gallery, and search by accession number, and search by title. So these are four options we gave. So you can search by anything, whatever you want to wish, like search by gallery. Suppose you want to search some gallery name. If you search the gallery name comes there. It is reserved there. So in reserve, this is the item present. So this is the item present. Suppose you want to see the details of this item, so you can click that button. There is an arrow button there, last corner. So you can see the details of backlink the icon, which is in the left corner of the site. So now you can click the icon. So you can see the details, that is gallery name, category, plus showcase number, accession number, your descriptions, and long description, and the image. You can see the image here, but at present the image is not there. So you can see the image of the item here. On mouse over, you can zoom the image. And this is title, country, origin of place, error box, all details will be here. So you can see the all details of the item. So you can see now all details, gallery, category, showcase number, accession number, descriptions, long descriptions. Now you can go back, down button is there, back to search. So you can go back to the search option again. So now here you can search again by category wise. There drop down, automatically the category name will come in the drop down. So you can select from there, whatever you want, you can select from there, you can. And next is search by accession number. So all the accession number will be displayed here. So I'm selecting one accession number and clicking submit. Now we'll show the details of that number. So this is the process to see the view the item details for all the present items. And this all is display everything, whatever item present in the museum, all display everything here at once. So you can see from here everything. So next is master data. So in this you need to add the gallery name. All the gallery name is to add here. This is for adding, deleting, editing, updating, everything. This is the process. So if you want to create new, if you want to add any new things, you can click the new button. There is a new button. The first button is a new button. You can click, and then you can type the gallery name, whatever gallery name you want, type here. So I'm typing on name Daniel Gallery. So it is saved now. Now you can see here that is a gallery name added to the database. Suppose when you edit that name, you can click, there is a arrow mark there, hand single. So you can select that arrow mark, whatever and edit, that data will go to that text box here. So there is a button, update button is there. So you can edit the edit, and you can change the name. So I'm now saving again. Now the name changed. So this is the gallery name. All the update, delete everything will be done here. Next is your category name. So this category is linked to the gallery name. Suppose I've added new gallery, that is Daniel gallery. So in that gallery, I have to add some new categories like painting, canvas painting, like that. So I'm selecting the Daniel gallery name and I'm putting the category name. And painting. So I'm saving it now. So now it is saved. It is Daniel gallery name and category name painting. Next is your attribute. Attribute means your item descriptions like title, what is the weight of that object, dimension. All that you can add here. You can see down there is a title, country, origin place. So here you must add all details. So adding is the same process for everything here. When you go to the new button, click and add the new name and save it. Next is your item value. Item value means there is item descriptions like title, name, dimension, origin of works, everything. So if you want to add any new material title, so you must add here. So you can see the title name here. All the paintings, painting names here. Next is your adding new material. This is a place where a new item, suppose new item comes, you must enter the item to the database first before writing the tag. So you must enter all details here, gallery name, category name, showcase name, registration number, and the descriptions. So I'm entering some default accession number. You can see there is a left icon is there. So you must select the left icon and select the item name from here. So I'm selecting some default value. So after selecting, the value will be displayed here. You see it automatically come here. There is two buttons here. One is for creating the descriptions. Another is for creating long descriptions. So create the long descriptions, all the gallery name, category name, accession number, title will display here. Whatever everything is there, long descriptions will display here. And here you can select the image of the artifacts, what is present. So select, I have selected on image. Now we can, now there is a last button, there is a save it, save button. So you can save that now, so that new item is now saved. We need to wait some time. So next you can see there is a edit button is there. Suppose when you edit some item, like some item descriptions and title. So you can select that item from here. So that is a, that is displayed by category and gallery ways. So from here you can select one item. There is a arrow mark left side. And submit the next button. So the details will come to here. So here you can edit the item. And that is save button is there. So after this, you can save the item and it will be saved. Now next is the dashboard. In dashboard, you can see the reports. So here you can see all item present, missing item, and what are the missing item, you can see the reports here. So you can see there is a total item 452. So there is three button. All artifact reports, missing artifact reports, and present artifact report. So if you click on all artifact reports, so there will be a pop-up displaying all details. So here you can filter by gallery ways. Suppose you want some gallery reports, you can select the gallery name from here. And you can take a printout from here. There is a print button there. So you click the print button. So automatically the print will come out from here. Next is the missing artifacts. So in this, you can see the missing artifacts. So for this, we need to go with the handle header and read the item first and come to the system. Then you can check the item here, what is missing or not. And last, this is the user.
সেন্স জোন কতটা সেন্স ডিসটেন্স বা সেন্স জোন কত 5 10 মিটার হয়ে
যাবে
5
10 মিটার
5 10 মিটার
ডিসপ্লেতে দেখাচ্ছে তো তিনটে আছে
এখানে তো পাঁচটা আছে
আসুক
শর্ট রেঞ্জে টেস্ট করুন আপনি, এখানে আপনার 1 2 3 4 5 6 6টা
এই দিকের একটাও পড়ে নি, 33 ওইখান থেকে হয়েছে,
না না এই বলছি শর্ট রেঞ্জে টেস্ট করুন, এখানে 6টা আছে
6টা আছে, জানছো কি করে? এটা তো 10 ফুটের মধ্যে দিয়ে এইটাই নিচ্ছে, তুমি ঠিক করে জানছো
আইডিটা দিয়ে উঠে আসে নাম্বারের সাথে,
সেটাই তো বল
এটাই কি না
আইডি দিয়ে এনক্রিপ্টেড
মানে আগে খুলে দিলে
নিশ্চয়ই মাথায় লাগাই দিবে
হাত পারে সুপারম সব পেইন্টিং এক জায়গায়
বল এরকম করতে
পুরো লম্বা হতে হবে
শুভেন্দু আমাদের অ্যাটেন্ডেন্সে যদি করে আই কার্ডটা দেখে দিয়ে আমি ফিনিশ হয়ে যাবো, এইরকম ব্যাপার
না শুধু এইটুকুর জন্য বাকি বাইরে
সেটিং এ গিয়ে ডিটেইলস লিস্ট
ধরলেই হয়ে যাবে
এটা স্টার্ট করব
এখন যে করছে তাকে একটু দেখতে হবে এটা নিয়েছে কিনা
এখন নেয়নি আপনি নেয়নি
এটা করবো কেন নিচ্ছে
উপরে নিচে নেই নিচে নেই উপরেই আছে
দূর থেকেই হয়ে যায় দূর থেকে দেখতে পাবে
will be coming in the next phase.
Ei shot eta nilo oita nilo na
rectification required regarding the position of the tag will redact and put it in accessible this way. I think we will put in the lower side in
the upper side
no
from upper side
ready chhe na
niche ada correct ay jashe it is
stable ready niye chhe
in that case it won't take any
আগে একটা দেখাচ্ছিল কিন্তু এক দিয়ে শুরু হয়েছে
আরেকটা